हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय चैनल माइंडफुल कॉन्वो। सो प्रीवियसली वी हैड डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द फ्लो डिसीजंस एंड द अदर डिसीजन एक्टिविटीज इन आरपीए। नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द वेरिएबल्स एंड द आर्ग्यूमेंट्स इन आरपीए। बेसिकली व्हाट इज वेरिएबल? एज द नेम सजेस्ट, इट इज एसोसिएटेड विद द वैल्यू दैट कैन चेंज। In UiPath, variables are of different types that have different data types, hence can store multiple type of data, whether it is text, number, data table, date and time. Variable pass data to other activities. So now we can see in the UiPath studio, where is the variable and how can we create the variable. So as we can see in the variable panel, we have four features like name, variable type, scope and default. So one by one we're gonna discuss about all these things. First of all, we will come to name. In this, we have to give name to the variable keeping in mind the naming convention, that is camel case. So it means we need to make the variable in the camel case form. Then as our second option is variable type. In this variable type, we choose the type of variable, whether it's text variable. If it's a text variable, then we need to select the variable type as a string. If we want to store the value as boolean, then we need to store the variable as boolean. As we can see that there is a drop down under the variable type that contains the various variable types, that is boolean, int 32, string, object, data or data table, array of t, and there are various other options and we can browse for the other types. Now what do we mean by the scope? The scope is the area in which the variable is accepted depending upon the activity type, whether it's a sequence or a flowchart. As we can see that I have already taken the sequence from the activities panel, so we can see that in the scope, the sequence is selected by default. Now the next is default. Default is an optional field. By default, it shows the value of the, it shows the by default value of the variable. Okay, now we will come to the arguments. So as we can see that there is another tab, arguments, behind the variables. So what do we mean by arguments? Just as variable pass the data from one workflow to another, same as arguments pass the data from one activity to another. Arguments are also of different types. Hence, we can create different types of arguments, whether it's generic, text, boolean, string, etc. So we have four features like name, direction, argument type, and default value. In name, we can use the title case naming convention. And when we come to the direction part, it means that we need to select the direction for the argument. There are three types of direction: in, out, and in slash out. I think there is a drop down too. Then if we name the argument as argument 1, then we can see in the drop down that in, out, and property. Basically, we use all these three: in, and out. We don't use property. So in variable, argument used only within the workflow. If we choose the out as direction, then the argument pass the data outside the workflow. If we choose in slash out, then it will pass the data both inside and outside of the workflow. Then the other is argument type. It is a mandatory field in which we need to choose the argument type. Types of arguments are boolean, int 32, string, object. These, we can see that these argument types are same as the variable types. In default value, we can see that it provides a default value to the arguments. So that's it for today. Stay tuned for other videos regarding the RPAs, and please don't forget to subscribe and like my channel, and for any other queries you can comment me in the comment box. Goodbye.